Hi, I'm Margaret. In this video, we are going to modify the Hello World label we started before. And I'm also going to show you how you can go to source view to structure your code. We want to make sure that not all the code is written in the constructor, and we want to set ourselves up with a code that is clear, easy to read, easy to maintain. So let's get started. I'm going to open Demo Window Builder. This is the Hello World label. Just as a quick reminder, let's run it so we all know how it looked like. And there it is. Hello World, bold, nice and big, centered. Notice that in my constructor, we have all the code for our label. What I would like to do is the following. I would like to extract a method. And this is one of the refactoring techniques, and it allows me to have a method that specifies the details of my label. For example, the foreground, horizontal alignment, font, etc. And all I need to know in my constructor is that I create a label and that I'm going to place it in my center position of my border layout. So I'm grabbing all the code from line 47 to 50. I right click, I say refactor and extract method. Notice here on the right hand side it shows you Alt Shift M. This would be a keyboard shortcut to extract a method. And now we're asked for a method name. I'm going to call it new label hello world. And Eclipse created a private method for us, new label hello world. It creates a label, still with the same text, hello world. It sets all those different properties, foreground, horizontal alignment, and font, and then it returns the label for us. And in our constructor, all the information we have is that we have a local variable label hello world. It gets created in my method new label hello world, and we place it in the center position of our border layout. So the nice thing about this method is the following. As I keep adding more information to my label, for example, I specify my background color or many other properties that I might be interested in specifying, all this information is going to be added to my method. It doesn't clutter my constructor, and it allows the reader or the other programmer who wants to work on your code to drill down, to look at the constructor, see all the labels, buttons, text fields we might want to create here, where they are, and then drill down for further information on the individual J components. So at this point, I'm going to run my program again. This was a form of refactoring, so my GUI should look exactly the same it used to, and yes, it does. We still have Hello World, dark blue, bold, centered. So now I switch to my design view, and we are going to set the background color. From last time, we still might remember that we have this property area, but this time it says no properties are selected. I need to go to my GUI and click on the property I'm interested in my case the label. So I make a click on my label and it fills this area with my label hello world. And once again, I have all the information. I have the foreground that I had changed to navy. I have my horizontal alignment that I had changed to center, but we have not done anything to our background yet. So I'm going to my ellipse here. I'm choosing a nice background color. And for right now, I would like this gold here. And I say, okay. Takes a moment. I can see background is gold. Surprisingly though, here, my background is still as gray as ever. Even if I run my program and I think, well, maybe this is just a little glitch in my design view, I can convince myself, no. My GUI still has a gray background. I'm going to tell you why. Labels are by default transparent. That's just something we need to be aware of. Yes, I can set my background, but it doesn't have an effect because the label is transparent. So I need to set my opaque property. And if I check my different choices here, they are listed in alphabetical order for the most part. I can see nothing about opaque here. The way WindowBuilder works is the following. It gives us frequently used properties, very easily accessible right here, but it doesn't list all of the properties. The reason it doesn't list all of the properties is the following. It can be distracting to have too much information available right away. But if we need it, we can go to this icon. Here it says Show Advanced Properties. I'm clicking here. All of a sudden, I have many more choices. And as I scroll down, I find something that is called opaque. Right now, opaque has a checkbox that is not checked. So opaque is false. It's not opaque. But if I check this checkbox, then opaque is true. And yes, I can see my golden background. And if I run my label, my result is a label with a golden background. Let's have a brief look at the source view to see how that affected my code. Notice, my constructor didn't change. My constructor still says we have a local variable, label hello world. We create a new label hello world. We put it to our border layout in center position. But what it means to have a new label hello world, that changed. So here we added a new instruction. We set our opaque property to true and we set our background property to gold.